Also, the Aussie survivor tells of the horror. Plus, Britney Spears' exclusive interview with Mike. Always the one. A current affair next.
At US airports, which made it pop sensation Britney Spears, very much playing down her image as the music world's Lolita. That's a little later, but we begin one-on-one with Britney Spears.
My mom's getting on to me because I'm taking a lot of days off. She's like, Britney, you need to work, okay?
We'll get them out.
When will America retaliate? Who's in their sights? What will happen when Wall Street reopens? How will Australia be affected? Complete coverage through the night with a live Ray Martin special, Crisis in America, 9:40 tonight on 9.
When pop sensation Britney Spears set out on her Australian promotional tour last week, everything still seemed right with the world. By the time she arrived here, all that had changed. And so did Britney Spears' itinerary. She cancelled a press conference and made arrangements to return home. But she did keep one engagement, an interview with A Current Affair that began with her reflections on the enormous tragedy back home.
I was heartbroken. You know, these are only things that you hear about in movies and stuff, and it really just, it's a reality check and puts everything in perspective.
Have you spoken to your mum and dad?
Yes. Oh, the first thing I did when I got off the plane was call my mother.
Because of the catastrophe in America, Britney was forced to cancel her world promotional tour and spend several extra days in Australia, swimming at Bondi, shopping, and doing interviews about her meteoric career.
Thanks, Britney.
Now, can you tell us about those early performances as a toddler in front of the bathroom mirror?
Always did that, yeah. Such an entertainer, yeah.
Already an entertainer.
Yeah.
With the hairbrush, I believe?
Oh, yeah. Oh, the hairbrush and everything.
Here's 10-year-old Britney Spears.
One of your first big breaks was as a member of the Mickey Mouse Club.
Wow, so many people have left the show and done so many wonderful things. I think it was a good, you know, experience for us. Just, I mean, we had the best singing coaches, the best dancing coaches.
Then, at only 17, Spears became the first artist in history to have a single and an album both go number one in the first week of release. The hit, Baby One More Time, sold 20 million copies.
Hit me, baby, one more time.
Honestly, I just wanted my single to play on the radio. I wanted it to play on the radio at home and for my friends to just hear it and feel cool about myself, you know? And, you know,
so what do you put it down to?
I
mean, did you tap into the teen explosion around the world? I mean, apart from your talent, what was it?
You know what? I don't know what it was. I think God has a plan for all of us, and that was his plan for me, bottom line, you know?
And you are very religious, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. You pray every night still?
Oh, yes.
What do you talk to God about?
What do I talk to? You know, I pray for my family. I pray for the sick and the needy. I pray, I voice my wishes, and I tell him what, you know, I want to do within the years and what I want my life to be like, you know, 10 years from now. And I, you know, that's what I pray for.
I did it again.
And incredibly, the Queen of Teen did do it again. At 18, with this hit, she sold more than 20 million copies.
I'm not that innocent.
To many, you are a contradiction. On the one hand, you're a sweet, innocent, virginal type. On the other hand, you're a sexy vamp in underwear.
I wouldn't say in underwear.
Rolling Stone?
Oh, well, on the cover of Rolling Stone, that was the only time.
Yeah.
But not when I perform, no.
Okay, well, you can see what I'm getting at.
I understand what you're saying.
So how do you explain that contradiction?
An example I like to use is little kids once a year that have recitals. when they go on stage, they put on their little tutus and their tights and their tap shoes. Their mom fixes their hair and they put on makeup. And they act really cute. It's their time to play and have fun, but they don't wear that to the supermarket.
So what do you say to the American Family Association, who tried to have your music banned when they labelled it a disturbing mix of childhood innocence and adult sexuality?
I think that they need to not take life so seriously.
Like get a life and,
you know, and just, you know, it's not that deep. So
you're no Lolita?
No.
No. I'm sorry.
Britney Spears is an extremely likable young woman, and at only 19, she knows exactly what's important in life.
Well, the past year, I've really put my foot down and wanting, like, a lot of time off to be able to be with my family, because the past 2 years, I've been really busy on the go. I mean, if this is my life and this is the lifestyle I'm going to leave, I have to make it as normal as possible. So when I'm touring, I have 2 days off now. I have, actually, I'm kind of, my mom's getting on to me because I'm taking a lot of days off. She's like, Brittany, you need to work, okay?
Because I think you wanted every weekend off and then a week off every 6 weeks.
Yes, and then, well, actually every 4 weeks. And then for the next tour next year, I have like 4 days off, and not 2 days off. So, yeah, you have to do that to stay sane. You have to. And my family comes before everything, you know, so I have to spend as much time with them as I can.
Okay, well, thanks for speaking to us, and enjoy the rest of your time in Australia.
I will. Thank you.
And Britney's latest single, I'm a Slave for You, goes on sale early next month. Back after the break.